I want to focus today on public buildings and on culture. And what is maybe remarkable, what people sometimes do not understand, is that all these buildings look different. And why they look different is because of the philosophy, people, place, and purpose. Because in architecture school you learn a lot. When I studied, I don't know if it's still now, but it's very much purpose-driven. You know, you have so many square meters and you have to do this and these functions. But you know, working for now than more than 35 years, I think, you know, functions are always changing, so why we should be so much purpose-driven? Place is extremely important. Place as climate, place as the soil, what kind of trees do grow there, what kind of culture, what kind of people. And of course, the first thing for me is the people. And you could say that at the end, a lot of things are always changing, are very specific, but people all over the world are not so different, I can tell you. It's about a certain size, spaced around people, about a certain size you design, but it's very much about the senses, hearing, feeling, touching, looking, but also about human values, that you like to take care of your children or your parents, or that you want to create communities, or that you want to create space for children to play. All these kind of values are for me extremely important. So that's why it's people, place, purpose, and also in that order. And a fellow architect, a friend architect, told me, Francine, you should really add poetry to the three P's, because he thinks the work is also very poetic. Let's go to Taiwan. This is Kaohsiung, it's a picture of Kaohsiung. This is a tropical city. It means several things. For instance, that at 6:30, in half an hour time, it's dark. And then the city comes alive, much more alive. People sit outside. You can just eat in the streets. It's very colorful. Of course, that's part of the Chinese culture. People, we had to design this performing arts center, but I saw a lot of things happening just underneath trees, underneath canopies, just in the middle of the street. A lot of culture is from original, not meant to be in this kind of spaces. You know, the culture, the origin of culture is very the streets, and maybe also for me the informality. And if you look at this picture, this is again, this is Kaohsiung, this harbor city, where they used to have this enormous military compound. It's an area, this is like 800 by 800 meters. It was a gated space, fenced off with barracks in between. And I remember going there for the very first time, and I saw empty barracks, I heard barking dogs, and I saw the banyan trees that were positioned between these barracks. And these banyan trees became our inspiration. Because trees, I always, when I observe cities, I always also look at not only to the people, but also to the trees. Because trees, they say something about the soil, they say something about the climate, they even say something about the culture. Because what is happening, it's really this, it's a tropical tree, it just continues, this is one tree that just continues. It's creating a crown that protects you from the rain and the sun. And it's at the same time, it's catching the wind of the ocean to cool you down. But we also did like the formal language of the tree, what has a kind of continuation. What we did as a concept, that we have these banyan trees, and we transformed it into the biggest performing arts center in the world underneath one roof. It's an opera house in the middle. On the right-hand side is the music. It's a recital hall and a concert hall. And on the left-hand side is more the spoken words. In between, I always had to explain to people it's open air. It's a ventilated tropical space. And where the roof, our crown of the banyan, touches the park, it becomes an open-air theater. It was simple like that. It's a rendering we made in 2006. The idea was the theater starts in the park. And again, very much combining the formal with the informal culture. Being aware that part of the culture, of the Chinese culture, is very much colorful light. How can we adjust light in it and how they can play with it? That was for us very important. Being aware that it's a very big, big building, we had some challenges how to make it exactly. And we came up with the idea to do it like a cargo ship, linking to the culture of and the identity of the city. The shipbuilding industry made this, what we call the Banyan Plaza, they made it. And what was for us very essential, that we really wanted to make it like a cargo ship. You know, with a kind of almost rough detailing, not like a luxury yacht, for many reasons. Also, we didn't have the budget for a luxury yacht, but also to give this gives some texture and some identity to the people who make these cargo ships in Kaohsiung. Also, what we wanted to make really a place with also with the detailing of a shipbuilding. To make the way we do the text, or we put even here, you know, how many meters you're above sea levels, or hoist that you can hang things in it, because we thought, you know, maybe they want to hang banners or something like that. The process of building it was, I think, an unforgettable experience. Here you see some pictures of the Banyan Plaza, how you enter it, the foyer space, getting into the building, and then get into the concert hall. What is a beautiful concert hall with a double organ, a recital hall, asymmetric. Here you see it with almost these color elements into it. And the playhouse, it's the Meccano blue one, was the most flexible one, and the opera house. With all having its own color and identity. Also developing all the fabrics that were made in the Netherlands, very high quality. But here I want now to focus with you, you know, what's happening in it. You know, this is what's happening in that building, making it as part of the culture of all people of Kaohsiung. You know, we could never imagine, as I told you, I want people to hang things on the ceiling. I had no clue to be what. I was just thinking of maybe they want to hang Chinese vlaggen. I don't know where. But, you know, I could never imagine that this would happen. Or yoga classes are now happening there. Or here, they're really doing projections in... on the screen. That's had the idea, but it's so funny they put in these headsets on it, you know. That's it. And here you can see it. You're in this ventilated space, not air-conditioned. Even if you have no money to pay a ticket for going to a concert, you know, you can enjoy it. This is all happening there. Here you look back from the opera house back into the Banyan Plaza. Children, we also could never imagine that they even take off the shoes. And start, here their shoes, and they start to use this as a slide. The building, how it fits in the park, and how it was the opening. One of my dreams, I have many dreams as you know, was to invite that the Rotterdam Philharmonic, what is of course from the harbor city of Rotterdam, from the Netherlands, would play here in the Kaohsiung. And that happened like now, 2 weeks ago. And first of all, so we went again to the, because, you know, at a certain moment, the building is done and then you don't come so often anymore. And, you know, it's also a little bit saying goodbye. This was happening, you know, can you imagine that this is happening? They hang things here. We could never imagine that this was happening. Also, what was a big discovery 2 weeks ago, they just put a grand piano in the space. It's there for 24 hours, 7 days a week. And people are using it, waiting in line to play it. Also, what I was extremely impressed by, for instance, if you go to a performance, there is a preview, this picture here in the corner, a preview talk. You know, it's fully booked by 200-300 people really listening to know what they are going to see later. This is all done by Wen Ping. I think it's great what we're doing. I think creating communities is for me always very important. He felt that if you're playing there as a symphony orchestra, you really feel very much connected to the audience. So it feels like one community. If you ask me about, you know, Francine, tell about designing for culture, what does it mean for you? I try to share with you some of my thoughts, what is important for me with that in my background.
The idea of culture is changing. Culture and learning are converging to a large extent, and culture is reaching out rather than being this exclusive property, which I think what we were talking about just now. But also there's this digitalization of our culture, you know, in its content and in its delivery. So with this very, very big change from what we thought maybe 25 years ago, how should a contemporary culture venue react to these changes?
I think with the examples I showed to you, it's already, that's why I selected them, it's already, you see that also the culture institutions and libraries, they are changing, they're reaching more out to the public. I don't know exactly what's happening in London, to be honest, but I can imagine it's also happening here. I remember when I was a student, you know, that was it, the culture was more for the elite, and you as a curator had to be, you know, to think of people, and the public was even not, that was not hot, you know, it was much more elite style. So I think also the curators are very much changing. That's why I showed you, you know, I am really impressed what they do, the creative director, who's now there working for 2 years in Taiwan, in Kaohsiung. I think they're doing a great job, you know, really and making programming for this, all these layers of people, and also for the young generation. I think it's amazing. For me, it's a very important example. But even what they're doing also in Birmingham, I think it's a great job. And also be aware, that's what I did experience with Birmingham. At that moment, they did ask for an icon. I said, I'm not going to make an icon. Maybe it will be an icon, but it should bring much more coherence. And for me, it's often, yeah, maybe this is very old-fashioned, but you know, it's public money. It's a public building. So you want to give it back to the public, that they feel that it's made for them and not made for me.
Right, a people's palace, you say. To a certain extent, and I hope I don't sound too cynical here, because I love the Kaohsiung Center for the Arts, isn't what we have there a sensational building that puts the city on the cultural map? Isn't it a little bit of the Bilbao effect there?
It's nice that you mentioned Bilbao, but I remember winning the competition like 12, 13 years ago, and I was talking to the client, the government there, and they said for them, because they don't even know of Bilbao, they said for us it's like the Sydney Opera House. We really want to invest in the country, and maybe it's now a little bit still over the top, maybe, but it's an investment for the next 25, 50 years. We want to stimulate this young generation, to stimulate them for culture and for music and all these events. But we also want to attract that everybody wants to play here from the whole world, that they want to come here to play it. And that's what maybe made my trip like 2 weeks ago so extremely happy. You can see that the musicians and the people who perform there, last weekend was the Nederlands Dance Theater, but also the Berlin Philharmonic, and all these people have been playing now there. They all love it, so they like to come back. And at the same time, what was for me so nice to feel, you know, the audience that is so enthusiastic, but also what was happening now in Banyan Plaza. You know, that I could never imagine that the conductor, the maestro, is playing there and with these kids. Did you see the faces of these kids?
Yes, yes.
They will never forget this in their life.
Yeah, this is true.
And this is really putting a seed, putting seeds in young generation for the future.
And I guess that is that sort of at the heart of the difference, because you go down into this wonderful Banyan Plaza, anyone can come in. It's not like buying an expensive ticket to the absolutely wonderful concert halls above. It's like, you know, it's not exclusive. That's a fair summary, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think it's beautiful architecture, but it's really meant, the goal was the people, to inspire the people.